which are notoriously forgettable, so they usually leave the solution hanging around somewhere. Get into the apothecary. Get a load of those choppers. They can't eat me because I'm a ghost, but they can for sure mess you up. Good luck with that.
We meet at last. Well, that's the measure of you, isn't it? Nicely done. It appears your corpse met a sudden and seawaggy end.
Enchanted nose ring protected me from potion fumes. Well, let's go find the back door to the apothecary, and maybe we can figure out the next piece of my death puzzle.
Hey! You're not supposed to be here! I know everyone who's supposed to be here! Did you get him?
Yeah, there's something of mine true there. I can feel it. Gank those guys so we can find him.
Look me in the eye.
to sneak in. Locked off. Maybe we can melt the grate off? Looks like something I'd have done in another life. And by another life, I mean the one I had. Before I was ghostified. Wish I could remember why I traded on the Big Bosch.
So, your captain killed you for your rebelliousness.
I still can't remember exactly what happened. But something bad went down, and now I feel too old for this. Huh. Ah, potion of acid splash. Ah, damn, that's a lucky find. Let's melt that grate. I mean, seriously, what are the chances that the exact thing we needed would be right here? Massive sea war pots. That's odd as I'll get out. It looks like someone was making a big old batch of sea war essence. Says here there's a huge shipment of so-called healing potions headed for Breikhoff. Could this be why I was killed? Did I try to stop this?
Sounds like exactly what I would label a nefarious brew, should I do something of the sort. Which I never would!
This doesn't look so good. I'm working on a theory. Let's keep moving. Wait, I hear something. Listen.
This be the last batch we're making for Brighton.
Yar! Captain says it be the strongest one yet! Town's not gonna know what hit him.
I remember now because of the thing they just said. Brighthorse in danger.
All this man? The Tilt-A-Whirl, yeah!
How'd I die? Answer me!
It's Rude Alex! I knew he'd come back for us!
Quick! Drink the potions! It's our only hope!
So that appears to be a Seawog transmogrification potion, and not, in fact, a
right? I'm so close to something here. Oh, that's my hand! Grab it! Wait, picking up my hand must have jogged my memory, because I just remember. This must be why they killed me!
I have to assume it was because of the potion that turns people into Seawogs.
Because of the potion that turns people into Seawogs! Every time you get one of my things back, I remember things. Derealism does weird stuff to our sense of identity, I guess. But look, we gotta get to the vat where they're making this potion and stop them from, you know, doing that. They were gonna use these potions to turn everyone in Brighthorn. And I just couldn't let it happen. It's one thing to shake a potion down for protection. It's another thing altogether to turn a whole town into Seawogs. Hey! Grenade. You guys suck!
You're gonna die too! Go, then, with a stain!
Miscellaneous projectile!
By the light.
Oh boy, this is existentially a lot. Guess I took a hook to the head while trying to shut this vat down. Too bad you weren't here for that one, huh? But I remember how to do it now. Crank the temperature on the vat. Should wreck the vat for good. So we just need to add something that'll make sure the current batch is ruined. An ingredient straight from the heck realm. That's it! Now throw it in the vat, and this potion's toast!
Tell me, rude Alex, what is this ruinous ingredient? Hair gel?
It's a pirate's secret. Although, they didn't shove a hook in my brain, so I guess I can tell you. It's pineapple. Add to anything, instantly work.
I find pineapple perfectly mediocre.
Now we just gotta stop them sending what they already made to Brighton. To the captain's quarters!
Though I struggle to understand how you could have such strong feelings about pineapple. I have strong feelings about protecting the people of Brighton. Onward!
Hey, I don't wanna argue, alright? Let's go. I'm coming for you, Captain Pirate. Watch your ass, you son of a gun!
So their big plan was to turn people into sea wargs and then steal from them.
Yes.
Wouldn't the sea wargs be even more dangerous than the people, though?
Well, I mean, yeah, sure, but what are they gonna do? Stop you from taking their stuff? Sea wargs can't exactly wear nice jewelry.
Why not?
Well, because I don't know, they don't have ears? Have you seen them wear jewelry? It made sense in my head, okay?
Okay, let's just suspend our disbelief here and help our pirate ghost friend, okay? Okay.
What in the name of drills, Barber? What now?
Surprise, Captain! I bet you thought you'd see the last of me.
Rude Alex, you failed to stop my plot against the people of Brighthoof in life, so now you return in death. I should have known you would be that bloody annoying. But the town is mine!
Evil shall never.
Thank you.
Did you avenge me? Well, you saved Brighthoof. Well, look, thanks for trying to put me around. It's not that I don't appreciate it, but I kind of want to return this place back to its former glory, you know?
Nothing can stop you from achieving your dreams. Not even a hook to the head.
You're right. And you're the best. I'll get to work on making this a place that actually helps me, instead of trying to turn it.
Let us taste of damnation!
Yes, yes, I'll return you to your tomb when our contract is done.
might have crept down to this, the deepest trench of the ocean depths. Ooh, I just remembered! You're gonna be one of my favorite characters.
I remember when I was your favorite. See how that turned out? Watch your back, Fate Maker, or you might find some fangs in it.
Meet at last.
A coiled priestess named Kasara stands before you. She seems to wish you no harm.
What are you doing down here, smooth skin?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. There's a little salt on the way she said smooth skin. I'm offended, I think.
Honestly, I don't even see what the big deal is about having skin. Sometimes skin's too dry, sometimes skin's too wet. Ugh, no thanks.
Yeah, you wouldn't get it. It's a skin thing.
Okay, the next person to say skin is spontaneously combusting!
She said it first!
Watch your tone with me. I am a squire of the realm, on an important quest, I might add.
I am sorry. It has been a very long time since I spoke with anyone. Of course, you seek passage. I can aid you. Here, take this cipher. Now, gaze upon the shrine, and let the words flow through you.
Eon! Drill! Ea!
What devil tongue is this?
Only the coiled may be granted passage through the drowned abyss. This cipher grants you our speech. There are three more shrines. You must intone their words aloud before the doors to the Temple of Sacrifice will open. This was once a sacred place to me and my sisters. Long ago, when we shared skies, before the days of chains, before the drowning. You must reach the Temple of Sacrifice. Inside is a light that will grant us passage.
Okay, she's creeping me out a little, and not just because she used the S word.
Yeah, she's got too many proper nouns going on. Chains, drowning, sacrifice.
What? No! She's right! I really want you to like her! You could have trusted the skeleton man just fine.
Yeah, he was a pirate.
Okay, well, with your detectability, you can tell that she's a real sweetheart who's honest and trustworthy, and you love her.
Yeah, but the priestess class has the conceal intent ability.
should have yielded when you had the chance. Turn back now and you might survive.
Singing their intoxicating siren song. They lured my men into their bone. Until their doom was terrible. I wish I could have saved them my own self. But I got trapped here when the whole blooming tank exploded and dropped this flotsam on me.
Jetsam?
Either way, please. Oh, put my men out of there and course of misery and in those twisted witches before they do more harm.
These foul temptresses must be stopped. The seas will be safe again.
Just so we're clear here, that now dead pirate was talking about sirens, right? As in the dangerous women that lure sailors to via drowning?
And not the magical ladies who are very real in our world.
Yepskis, you got it. Look at you two drawing conclusions and crap. The temple of the Slither Sisters is eerily quiet as you enter. I know what you're thinking, baby. What's the deal? Where are these ladies? And aren't they supposed to be singing?
I am not.
But then...
So, another fool has come to challenge us. Let us test your resolve.
Captain Claw!
So, what, we're just under the spell of these coiled ladies now?
Yep, gotta do whatever they say.
Sounds just like Carol.
Do I even wanna know?
Hell no!
It all started when our eyes met across a bistro.
Captain Claw, I am compelled to slay you! Do you hear me? You dishonor yourself by hiding! Show yourself and die! Hide behind your case, Shade. I will put them down.
I have
Wait, are those crabs talking?
And they sound real depressed, too.
Forces of darkness encroach! Darkness flees before the light!
I just wanna go!
ask myself the same thing on the day the Slither sisters cursed me and my crab brethren with consciousness.
I apologize, but I do have questions.
That's all consciousness is. An endless march of questions for which there are no answers. How can you stand to live like this?
By reading daily
It was a rhetorical question. All I want, all we want, is to return to a blissful life of scuttling to and fro without a care in the world. What a curse it is to care.
Poor cramps.
Please help us. Together we can destroy the sisters. First, you must destroy the clamplifiers, their magical resonance boosters which amplify and strengthen the power of their song.
Suppose the crabs couldn't destroy these clamplifiers themselves.
Excellent question.
Ourselves, but our claws are more decorative than folks imagine. We weren't ashamed of it until those damn sisters cursed us.
I'm learning so much.
Now that you've destroyed the clamplifiers, the sisters won't be able to charm you again. I'll meet you at the lair.
Lucky you.
Consciousness treating you, Squirt. And our champion. We had such high hopes for you. For shame. We'll keep the crab alive to wallow in the pain of his own existence. But you... we're gonna have some fun with you.
Goodbye, my friend. May you never have a thought again.